Hi, my name is Ian Van Tuyl, and behind me is a 2014 Jeanneau 57. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer. So this is the Philippion design Jeanneau 57. This particular vessel was built in France and is currently located here in the Coronado Cays. We have the air conditioning running right now, so that's what you see, the water coming out the edges. Again, it's just a remarkable vessel with a shiny hull. We have a varnished tow rail, antique decks. You're gonna notice that we have these inserts here, and this is for a side boarding ladder, making it really convenient to board and onboard the vessel when you're at a dock slip location. A couple things done in the model of 2014 is they've had these combings designed that kind of enclose all the sheets and halyards leading into the cockpit and allow you really nice access up to the cabin top. There are four large overhead opening hatches and nice forward skylights that'll just flood the salon with natural light. As we move up to the foredeck, you're gonna see again lots of opening hatches, and this is the forward VIP cabin. As we make our way up to the bow of the vessel, you're gonna notice another hatch here. This is access to the sail locker. The sail locker is quite unique in a sense because it really has a lot of volume and space. Just below this area is the bow thruster access, and you could convert this into a shop and or crew quarters, but really giving you lots of usable space and a great amount of stowage. Just forward of this is our Lumar windlass. This is a large 24 volt Lumar windlass. The anchor itself is a Lumar Delta anchor, and we have all chain. You're also gonna notice that we have a full fiberglassed in bulkhead that goes all the way down, acting as a crash bulkhead as well, providing additional safety to a vessel of this diameter. Up here we have two bow rollers, the tack attachment point, and again the large bow rollers set up for the Lumar Delta anchor. There is the swivel as well, and this is controlled from here and from the cockpit. Balmor has done a really great job of coming up with an electric furler. The electric furler is controlled from the cockpit, making this boat very easy to single hand and shorthand sail. It also has a manual backup system, so if anything were to happen, you could unscrew this cap and get a winch handle in there. Another thing I want to point out to you is the opening for the cleats. So this is quite nice. I love how they've opened this up and being able to let it back, because if you're in Catalina Island or you're in a mooring situation, it's easy to bring that line right through this, leading it properly to the cleat itself. Here's a great profile looking back aft. As we move our way back aft, we're gonna notice the large lifelines. These are really tall. They were extended at this year, really giving you a great peace of mind of walking up to the foredeck. We have a triple spreader mast with in-mast furling. As you can see, as we move our way up, we have the radar, a deck light, and then also spreader lights. This is a keel step mast, so it goes through the deck, and all the load bearing is down on the keel itself. All the sheets and halyards are led into the cockpit, and there's all Harken high load blocks at the base of the mast. We also have inboard sheeting and inboard shrouds. Talking about the shrouds, I want to point out to you, you see the flat edges on this? This is the upgraded die-form standing rigging. This is the strength of rod rigging with very low stretch. The Dodger itself was designed here in San Diego by Memos Custom Canvas. We have macro long glass, and this is the convertible Dodger. So you'll see these snap buttons leading up. This canvas piece folds back. This aft bow folds forward, making it like a convertible windshield. Really nice with integrated stainless steel grab handles. You can see here just the massive size of the cockpit, how much it really just induces the usability and space that it's given. As we move our way back aft, I want to show you the transom. The transom is dropped down right now, and there is a tender right on the transom. The dinghy garage is quite unique for a vessel of this size and really offers amazing amounts of space down below. And you can see that through additional photos through the listing. Here at the starboard helm, this is our main helm controls. We have our throttle controls off to starboard. We have our winch controls, which allow you to operate your Jeanneau winch and your main sheet winch. These are both electric on both starboard and port side. One thing I really like about this is while sitting here in this position with sails deployed, you have phenomenal visibility, but you also have control over your head sail and your main sail from both helms. Throttle is really nicely located here. We have our windlass chain counter with chain counting abilities, which allows you to monitor how much chain you deploy and retrieve. Our bow thruster controls, our electric windlass control, our fusion stereo control, and then we also have our lighting switches. This will allow us to turn on and off the additional lights throughout the vessel itself. We have a multi-repeater and an autopilot control head unit. Centrally located is a hybrid touchscreen Raymarine plotter. So here you can see that we're located right down in the case. And again, a phenomenal display that will pivot at different angles. At the port helm, we have another multifunction display unit here. This allows us to toggle through the different pages that we want to look at. And again, both autopilot can be controlled from the chart plotter itself and or at the starboard winch. And it's duplicated over here, again, with the electric Jeanneau winches and main sheet winches. Another thing I want to point out is the cockpit table. This is a large teak cockpit table. It houses an internal refrigerator and stowage unit with large teak leaves on both sides. Notice the diameter of the stainless steel foot rails and hand grabs. It also has built-in cup holders. As we move up, large seating throughout and electric two-speed rewind Harkin winches. Typically on this, you will be able to furl in and out your mainsail and be able to adjust for spinnaker halyard, your outhaul, and boom vane. The companionway hatch is quite nice. It is very, very large. Both doors come together and they're counterbalancing as well. So depending on what heel you're at, you never have to worry about these closing. Either opposing doors keep themselves open. And again, phenomenal visibility to the foredeck. So let's go down below and see what she has to offer. As we come down below, I'm going to show you the nice gradual steps. We have the galley off to the port side. The galley is quite nice. It really gives you lots of space here. It accommodates drawers, shelving, and trash compartments. We have a dish drying rack, and we also have a double stainless steel sink. We have very high-end European-style faucets with also a foot pump switch for salt and fresh water. Just next to this is our dedicated deep freezer. As you can see, is a deep storage area. And then we also have the refrigerator. The refrigerator space also has a freezer compartment inside the refrigerator and also a front loading door. This is quite nice because it allows you to gain access to the bottom of the refrigerator. Just after this is our three burner stove and oven. And as you can see, we have the Corian countertop that closes this off, allowing you to use countertop space. But when not in use, this folds back and you have access to your stove and oven. Just above that is our light with fan fixtures as well too, additional cabinetry storage, and amazing amounts of storage just aft of the oven. Cabinets are found throughout. They also have self-dampening closing hinges and drawers. A really nice touch to the Jeanneau yacht. Just aft of the galley is our aft cabin. Now the aft cabin is set up quite nice, so you can actually have two split berths and or the outboard berths slides in, making it a queen size bed. but amazing amount of headroom. I can walk all the way back to the large aft window here that opens up and acts as also an escape hatch. You also have another opening hatch here. Nice central little area. Lots of lights and lots of cabinets throughout. One thing I like about this aft cabins is they're mirrored on both starboard and port side, but you also have access into your private head and shower compartments. This is a Japsco quiet flush electric toilet. You have large vanities, mirrors, overhead opening hatch, and your shower compartment. As we move back forward, I also just want to point out the attention to detail, the really high-end fixtures, the thickness of the doors. There's magnet locks on all of the doors, being able to keep them open. LED floor lights as well. Here gives you a really good view of the galley and the salon. Directly across from the galley is our nav station. The nav station is set up quite nicely. It gives you really good accessibility to your chart plotter, to your breaker systems. Just aft of the tank monitoring gauges is our additional breaker systems. This allows us to activate the air conditioning outlets, our generator, our inverter, our ship to shore breakers. But all of this is conveniently located in this cabinet, so you don't have to look at it. Keeps it nice and clean looking. And there's additional stowage down below here. Again, the attention to detail with the leather wrapping on that is quite nice. We also have our Raymarine VHF located up there. And lots of cabinets, lots of stowing, access to all of our components. Underneath this seat is a large stowage area. This particular stowage area is set up for a washer and dryer, so if you so desire it. And then there is a hanging locker stowage cabinet for foul weather gear with a built-in drain as well too, right behind the nav station. Now let's go into the second aft cabin. And as I mentioned to you earlier, this is a mirrored image of what we were just looking at to the port. Quite nice. Again, this outside berth slides in, pins into place, making it a queen size berth. So if you have a couple on board and or kids, it really accommodates quite nicely. Again, a Japsco quiet flush electric toilet here, great vanity, lots of mirror space, lots of stowage, and an overhead opening hatch. As we move back forward into the salon, you can see the flat screen television mounted up on the bulkhead. We have a beautiful salon table. Now this is the luxury salon table, and what makes it so luxurious is not only does it have folding leaves that go in and out, but you also have a base that will drop down and turn into a coffee table, and that controller is located right here. So by a push of a button, this will actually go from a salon table down to a coffee table, making it quite nice. And as you can see, there's two nice luxurious chairs that will also accompany the dining room table. Directly across from the dining room is our couch and love seat. The couch and love seat is set up quite nicely with leather inlays. It also has a built-in bar. This lifts up and gives you access to the bar. And then below this seat also is a great area that flips over, and it turns this into a little coffee table. Directly across, again, from the television, we have our stereo controls and our Blu-ray DVD player system. I also have a USB input to the Fusion stereo. The stereo can be controlled from here with a remote and or up in the cockpit, as I showed you earlier. But we're here in the vessel, we're having the air conditioning run, the TV's running, so this gives you a good sound level of what it's like in the salon with the AC running. And again, we have large overhead opening hatches. This is quite nice because you have shades on one side, screens on the other. And again, shades over these windows here. But we're in the salon and we're just getting flooded with natural light. Now we're going to move up to the forward master cabin. Now this is one spectacular cabin. We have a full hanging locker located here, just forward of that is our desk and vanity. And you can see what an amazing bed. Center line, queen berth, amazing amount of headroom. If you have anybody, significant other that you know, feels claustrophobic, this is the layout that they're gonna absolutely love, because phenomenal headroom, great amount of space, large windows here, so when you're laying in bed, you can always look out. And again, a massive amounts of cabinetry. Again, look at the shock details that they use on all of the doors. It's just quite impressive, the attention to detail, the Corian strip that they ran in through the teak countertops, the leather wrapping, the little trays next to each bed, reading lamps. It just goes on and on. There are four opening hatches here, five opening hatches here in this forward cabin, and one in the private head and shower. Now, the head and shower set up quite nice with electric Japsco quiet flush toilet, molded Corian sinks, great fixtures and faucets. Look at this shower, pretty remarkable. And what I love about it is they don't designate too much space for a shower. You have this collapsing smoked glass door that just locks into place, and now your shower's completely encompassed and really does a phenomenal job here. And within seconds, you can put this back and have a full use of space for your head compartment. Quite nice. There is a stowage underneath the bed as well too. This lifts up. There's gas shocks under there, built-in safe, and just lots and lots of natural light flooding this compartment. You also have a full-length mirror as well, which is quite nice. This will give us another perspective of the salon. Looking aft, found this video to be helpful and informative. And if you like any more information about this amazing vessel, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. Thank you very much. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again for watching.